स्वभाव चिन्मयानंदम कृपा पूर्णम जगत्पतिम हरिषड्वर्ग जेतारम नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे। स्वभाव चिन्मयानंदम कृपा पूर्णम जगत्पतिम हरिषड्वर्ग जेतारम
सदाशिव समारंभाम शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। Let me first tell the story, then we will see that. Me. See, it was Narada who is the one who started everything. This Narada is like a communication minister of those days. He used to take message from here to there, there to here, that is his only work. And he will not just take, he will twist it. He will give his own twist. One day he saw the jewel on the chest of Vishnu, new jewel, Shamantaka. Beautiful, shining jewel on the Vishnu's chest. And he asked Bhagavan, from where did God get that? He said, some devotee gave. Maybe Varuna Raja, king of the king of the ocean, Varuna Raja gave. And Narada was thinking, oh God, such a pretty jewelry. But somehow he wants to have a little fun. Went and spoke to Indra, greedy fellow. See, Vishnu was not greedy. Because the devotee gave, he was peering it. It was there on his Srivatsa. Srivatsa means his birthmark, Vishnu's birthmark. And that Shamantaka was sitting. Srivatsa can be called like a dwart. What do you call it? Wart. Like a wart, it was a little big birthmark. Maybe that can be the thing. So, Srivatsa. So he saw the Shamantaka and Srivatsa, and Narada went to Indra and said, Indra, look at this, Varuna, this fellow is your servant, but he took the Shamantaka and gave it to Vishnu. He did not give it to you. Then Indra got very much annoyed, but he can't tell that directly to Narada because he knows Narada will go and tell this to Vishnu. He knows Narada will go and tell this to Vishnu. He said, no, it is given to Bhagavan. It's okay, leave it. It should be with Bhagavan. But immediately he called Kubera and said, how dare that Varuna will hand over this to Vishnu without asking us? Because all the nidhi of planet Earth and the ocean. See, Sanganidhi, Badumanidhi. The Badumanidhi means the lotus which comes out of the mud, ground. Sanganidhi means the conch which comes out of ocean. So both wealth belongs to Kubera. Sanganidhi, Badumanidhi. Conch is the wealth of the ocean. All things comes from ocean. All jewels of ocean is denoted by Shankha, Kanch. All wealth comes from the land, is denoted by Badma, Batma, the lotus. So both belongs to Kubera. So how come Varuna go and hand over the Sanganidhi, which is your property, to Vishnu without your permission? this fellow cannot directly question Varuna. Then because Varuna will go and tell Vishnu, hey, Baba, I gave you and this guy is catching me. But going through the bureaucracy, the department. Now Kubera calls Varuna and straight away asks, how come this did not come to my treasury? Then Varuna says, you are Yaksha, he is Lakshmi. You see, the Yaksha means who possesses wealth but neither enjoys nor let others enjoy. Lakshmi means who keeps the currency moving, who enjoys and let others enjoy. The modern day economics theory. See, the modern day economics theory, they have described so clearly. Yaksha is a person who is sitting on the wealth. Practically, if the more Yakshas are there in your country, means the country economy will be low. India is filled with Yakshas. West is filled with Lakshmis. Guys who spend, who let the currency rotate, rotation gives value to currency, life to currency. Currency means what? It should be rotating. That is the currency. So Yaksha gives importance only to hold the wealth. Lakshmi means rotating the currency. The Varuna says, even if I give it to you, it will be sitting inside a treasury. Nobody will even know. Nobody will see. Don't you see how pretty it looks on the chest of Vishnu? So the Varuna says, that is why I offered at the feet of Vishnu. He is wearing. He is enjoying. Then Kubera makes a petition to Indra. No. This cannot be accepted. Now we don't know what all the wealth this fellow is hiding. Let us churn and bring everything out. Let us churn and bring everything out and bring the whole thing to treasury, now itself. Nothing should be left with the Varuna Raja. This is where the problem started. Now, both the Indra decides, we will churn the Varuna Raja, ocean of sea, and get all the wealth out and dump it in the Kubera's crusher, Yaksha. It should be under our control. It should not be left with Varuna anymore. They decided to churn. Now the problem is they do not want the higher authorities to know. It's like among the brothers they want to plan and do. Now the mantralosana starts. They decide, we will not inform or invite Trimurtis. Because the whole plan is against Vishnu. Because the jewel went to Vishnu, these guys are doing this journey. So, top level guys will not be called. Let us make friendship with the Asuras. Let us do. Let us do amongst ourselves. So that nothing can be done. Varuna goes and falls at the feet of Vishnu. Bhagavan, I don't know what happened. These guys are trying to do this. Vishnu asked, oh, what? Finally, Indra decided. Varuna says, they have decided to have friendship with the Asuras. Then Vishnu smiles, forget about it, then they will come to me, relax. Because they have bought the trouble. Now they have bought the trouble. The natural hair will run. They will go to, they will come to me only. Forget about it, I will take care. You just go and relax. He says, them to relax. Then both the fellows are deciding. Rakshasa and Devatas, demons and gods. Both of them decided, we will churn the ocean and get everything out. See, in India if you have seen that they will churn the milk, buttermilk, if anything is lying under that ocean, what will happen? It will come out. It will come out. Just like that, they want to churn the ocean. So now, both the guys came to the agreement, and that yes, we will churn the ocean, and they have decided the Meru Giri should be used as a what do you call mattu?
Like a stick.
Stick. No, there is a technical term for it.
Fulcrum, I think.
Center. No. That mattu has got a technical English word.
Axle.
Like axle, that is true. But there is a technical word for it. I know.
Fulcrum, I think.
There is a wooden piece. They will use that.
Blender.
Spindle. Spindle, okay. Alright, we can have the title spindle. Let's understand the word spindle. They have decided Meru should be a spindle, and the Adishesha, the snake of snake on which Vishnu is lying, that should be the rope. And after all the
is Meru located actually?
So, Meru is not actually the physical plane. Meru is the etheric plane. The Kailash and the physical plane is like an airport from where you can go to the Meru. It's an airport from where you can take off to the original Meru. That is why it is considered as a Meru. That is not Meru. That is a plane from where you can take off. And this fellow's decide, that's what the here now problem comes. That's what I'm saying, that's what that now that's where the problem starts. That's where the problem starts. The rope and the spindle, both of them decided. Now who will go and ask? You see, not only rope from Vishnu, the spindle is Shiva's. Shiva's spindle. And Vishnu's rope. But this fellow's wanted do without telling them. And now starts the fun. Now these guys are sitting and discussing what to do, how to get both of them out. How to get both of them out from the Vishnu. From Vishnu and Shiva, they have to get the spindle and the rope. But they don't want them to be part. They don't want them to be part because they may ask for a share whatever comes out. So now these guys have finally decided to send Narada as a representation. Narada is a representation. He goes there. Narada goes and says, Bhagavan, we need your Vasuki and the hill of Shiva, both for churning the ocean. Vishnu says, what is that? Please take it. And immediately he tells, please go. Vasuki goes. One moment Vasuki, Adishesha asks, what should I do, Bhagavan? Just go, I'll take care. Just go, I'll take care. And he says, you go. And then the next side, the hill, Mandar, spindle from Shiva. Narada goes and asks, Bhagavan, we need your Mandar. Your hill. Shiva says, what is that? Please take it. He also gave it away. After everything, all the things have arrived, now they are ready. Now they are ready with the whole thing to start the journey. Now fighting starts. The fight, you know, the fight is also again created by Narada. Narada says, Narada goes and slowly tells Devatas, see, Devatas are the leaders. So hold the head side, not the tail side. See how the fight starts, you know. Who will hold the tail of Vasuki? Who will hold the head of the snake? So all Devatas say, we are superior. We will hold the head. And Asuras say, then what? We are lower or what? We only will hold the head. And fight starts. immediately the fire starts and the drama is they already put the mandala on ocean. It is getting sink. It is continuously sinking inside. And here fighting is going on. Still even the churning is not started. But before that itself, fight has started. Fight has started between these two fellows. They saw that left and right the fight is going on. Suddenly, Indra was surrounded, arrested by the demons. Before even the fight starts. Before even the fight starts, Indra is already arrested. Now Narada runs again to the Vishnuloka. Oh Lord, what happened? We don't know. See what has happened. Then Vishnu laughs. You guys don't want us. Why are you coming now here? Then Vishnu, Narada says, no, now it is too serious. Please, you have to do something. You have to do something. All the devatas were remaining. All the chota guys, all of them run and fall at the feet of Vishnu. They say, please forgive us. It is Indra's mistake. It is not that we did. Please do something immediately. Then Krishna says, Vishnu says, all right, I'll do something. Go, I'll come. And he waits till that fellow exhausts his karma of suffering. He doesn't go immediately. This Indra fellow said no to Vishnu. Na? So how much karma he needs to suffer, that much time he is sitting silently. Sirgadi is the place where the Vishnu, where the Indra was imprisoned. See, now I am coming and connecting with all the sthalas. Alright, first I'll finish the story, then I'll step by step open up. And how? Because the Sirgadi temple story has got a great significance in enlightenment path. I'll come and open. Sirgadi is the place where the Indra was imprisoned by these demons and Vishnu waits enough. Then he comes down. Ari means ocean. Sirgadi means where the sin of the ocean got cleared. Ari means what? Ocean. Even in Sanskrit they have a word, I think. Ari means ocean. Sirgadi means the sin related to ocean got cleaned. So, this fellow, finally Vishnu decides to go. And he goes and says, as devatas are elders, they will only hold the head. But the demons, they try to catch Vishnu also. No, we will only hold the head. Then finally, Vishnu says, all right, we will come for a compromise. You guys will only hold the head. Then, if Amrita comes, first devatas will drink. Whoever wants to hold the head, they should give the other person priority in sharing the Amrita. This fellow says, that is okay. Anyway, after all, we are going to have our share. It's not a problem. But let us do it. It's a prestigious game. See, losing the wealth for the sake of ego is demon. Gaining the wealth along with ego is devata. Gaining wealth and enlightenment is rishis. Losing wealth also for ego's sake is demon. Understand? Having only ego, not even wealth, is asura, demon. Having ego and wealth is the devatas. No ego, wealth and enlightenment. Both are there. People who stay in the Vaikuntha are Kailasha, rishis, enlightened beings. So these guys, they are so crazy. They are so cranky. These fellows did not even have the idea that they are losing Amrita, nectar. But anyhow, they decided, all right, we will let go. Then Vishnu comes and tells the devatas. But the devatas fellows don't want to go for compromise. He told, fool, Vasuki will emit poison if she is going to be used as a rope. Because, see, continuously the Adisesha will be pulled this side and that side. What will happen? He will sweat. And the sweat, his sweat is poison. Will you guys be able to handle? They say, oh God, you saved us. You saved us. Then he says, come on this side. And go that side. Now the next drama starts. They start churning. The churning starts. And the sound which is created deafens the whole world. Deafens the whole world. And left and right, the churning is going on. And when the churning is going on, first the top level things started coming out. Like animals. The seahorse, what they call? Seahorse. All those things started coming out. Then the apsaras, the batala loga, whatever was there. Wealth, kamadenu, kalpa vriksha. Everything started coming out. One by one, one by one, one by one. And the funny thing is, anything before even it reaches the surface, some devatas or demons will go and catch it. It's mine, it is mine. Who finds it, he keeps it. Because so many things are coming out. Whoever finds things, they started taking it away. And finally, Lakshmi came and Vishnu said, all right, I will have her. He took it away. All the things, whatever came out, all these fellows have taken it away. Suddenly, that was the music, background music. Suddenly, this Adisesha, who became so tired, he said, no, no, give a break. I am not able to do anything. Because he became tired. But these fellows are so greedy. They said, no, no break. They are pulling and pushing. He became little longer. Because he became little longer, the spindle started sinking inside. Spindle started sinking inside. And because spindle started sinking inside, the overweight, he emitted the poison. He emitted the poison. The moment poison came, all the fellows, devatas or asuras, everybody, whole group left everything and ran away. Left everything and ran away. And the spindle is going down and down continuously. Immediately Vishnu took the form of a tortoise, went and held the spindle without sinking further, much further. And all these devatas ran to Shiva. God, please save me. Because already Vishnu is also in the job of holding the spindle. Actually, what Shiva gave, Vishnu took care. What Vishnu gave, Shiva took care. Vishnu gave Adisesha. So, Shiva took care of Adiseshas, the poison. What Shiva gave? A spindle. Vishnu took care of the spindle. Then Shiva says, all right, don't bother. I'll take care of the poison. He just took the poison and swallowed it. Swallowed it and put it at the feet, at the neck. Devi just holds the Shiva's neck and the poison stays there itself. That's another one great important thing you need to know. Even if poison is added to enlightened being, not only he does not die, the quality of the poison disappears. Even the quality of the poison disappears. That becomes a divine. So he swallows the poison and it stays in his throat itself. It does not work anymore. Then finally, the Vishnu balances the tortoise. Vishnu balances that Meru, spindle as a tortoise. The churning was done. Then finally comes out Amrita. From below, the Amrita Kata comes out. Amrita Kalasha comes out. The moment the Amrita Kalasha came out, all their agreement and morality lost. According to agreement, what was the agreement? Devatas will have the first share. And these asuras started running to catch the kalasha and finish it off. And these devatas are afraid because if it goes to asuras, what will happen? They will not get a even the water wash that part. These asuras won't give even the water which is used for washing that part to the devatas. And both the fellows are fighting. In between, in the gap, Dhanvantri, who is the lord of medicine, keeps that Amrita Kalasha secretly hiding in four places in the planet Earth. That is Haridwar, Allahabad, Nasik and Ujjain. See, our 12 years is the one shana for them. So in one shana, he changed three times. It's like income tax raid when it comes, how the people chase and put the money in different places, same way. And tagadaga, he just puts here, there, constantly. And these fellows are fighting. Finally, Vishnu takes a Mohini incarnation, takes the form of a seducing woman and says, all right, both of you stop fighting. I will share that Amrita and give you, nectar and give you guys. So the moment they saw the Mohini, these fellows forgot about Amrita. All the demons forgot about Amrita because for them nothing else is required. Forget about it. And now nothing else is required. And these fellows started running behind Mohini. And they said, yes, 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 we will obey as you say. Please, you do whatever you feel like. Whatever you want, whatever you feel like. Then Mohini said, all right, all of you sit in straight line. They sat this side. And all this side the devatas sat. This side the all demons sat. Mohini started serving the nectar to the devatas first. But these fellows have no guts to ask Mohini. And they were not in the mood to ask question Mohini. They were just sitting. But two fellows, two demons, Rahu and Ketu, even though they are seduced by Mohini, they are little cunning. They are little intelligent. They thought, let us go and sit that side and get the Amrita. So she was serving. These guys came and sat that side. And the story says, she did not, not only she did not serve, she just knocked the, both the guys with the same spoon which she was carrying. Which she was carrying, that's why they lost the head. They lost the head. That's why Raghu and Kedu do not have head. And they have become shadow. They don't have any more existence. Neither in Rakshasa group they agree them, nor in the demon group, Devatas group they keep them. So they are shadows. They are neither here nor there. They become they Raghu and Kedu. And finally the Amrita is served. And by the time the Devatas finished, Amrita Kalasa became empty. Became empty. And Mohini also disappeared. Mohini also disappeared. The story says because these guys drank Amrita, the demons are not able to kill them. The fight started and the demons were blasted left and right by this Devata's new power. All the demons ran away and hid themselves into the under the ocean. This is the story. Now let us enter into the truth behind the story. I am seeing already few fellows are sleeping. Hey Papa. Why suddenly all fellows are sleeping? Morning they were all right. What?
They drank Amrita already.
No, I understand. There is some time Maya will not allow so much understanding to happen. Maya will not allow so much understanding to happen. So be very careful. Maybe now you are getting slowly caught by Mohini.
So it's an Amrita, Kapha Amrita. Coffee.
But if we give one more break, so much time will be wasted. And where is the watch? But if you guys are sleeping, I will not talk. Understand? First step, Indra getting jealous of Vishnu's Shamantara. It always happens. Disciples get jealous seeing the status of master instead of state of the master. Understand? Instead of trying to achieve the state in which master resides, Vishnu resides, he wants to have the status of the Vishnu. That is where the problem starts. It can lead to enlightenment or to destruction. If you take the right turn at right place, even being jealous of the status of the master can lead to the state of the master. If you want to have same status, means what you need? State. So jealousy can become inspiration or perspiration. See, if you do what he did also, it can become inspiration. If you just see his only final achievement and do not create, do what he did, then it is perspiration. So all you need to understand, is jealous towards the master, do not become perspiration. That is where the whole thing starts. Now Indra is jealous of the jewel. And he thinks it belongs to him. All the rich fellows think the luxury and joy belongs to them, not to the enlightened being. That's a big problem. Big problem with the so-called rich guys. They think that they should only be joyful. That is why they are so angry when they see an enlightened master joyful. No, really, even conceptually, I know for sure. See, especially in Tamil Nadu, I know very, very many rich idiots. They don't come to me because I am smiling all the time in my photograph. No, really. So many fellows have made comments. I myself have heard. What? This fellow is all the time laughing. Why a Swami should laugh? Why a Swami, huh?
No, sir. They think enlightened master should not have gold or anything like that. That was the
thing. I have seen. These fellows think that joy, laughter or shamantara is their right because they worked for it. Indra works, does administration, then gets that as a salary. I just get it as a devotee's donation. Varuna comes and gives it to me. What can I do? Anyhow, these fellows are jealous and they start the drama. Now the problem is, they wanted to acquire all the wealth just by themselves, so that nothing else goes to anybody else. And they want to have the status, state or everything, all by themselves. They start the process. They start the process of churning. Actually the problem is, when the process starts, suddenly you realize, beyond you, something is required for success. Even when you work to achieve the wealth, beyond you, something starts, something is needed for success. That is why, that is where you send your prayers, Narada to the Vishnu. Narada goes to Vishnu. See, now the story takes a new twist. If you send prayers to the master, same person, The same jealous can become inspiration. Whoever has never sent a prayer, then what happens? It just remains as a perspiration. Now the story takes a real shift. Anyhow, knowingly or unknowingly, they have surrendered. They have surrendered to the same person to whom they are jealous. Surrender can come even through jealous. It's okay. Nothing wrong. But surrender is the whole thing needed. Surrender is what? Completely needed. Not the jealous.
Here, are they the acting of their own intelligence or just under the orders of India?
It is only under the orders of Indra. Indra.
Indra is the one who is jealous,
and Indra is the one who is responsible. I can say, Devatas, if they stood against Indra, then they are not responsible. But they have not stood against Indra. An individual should stand against even the leader if he is not completely in tune with ideology. This I can say. I always tell people, even if I put somebody in the front as a stage or a leader, as an Indra, as long as he executes my words, as long as he creates more devotion in you towards me, only then he is worthy of that seat. Understand? If he does something against, even though he is appointed by me, should be refuted by Hindevatas. So every step you should take care, create and have the company of only the people who intensifies your devotion towards the master and who executes your master's words. Then you are right. Otherwise the person who is in between you and master will become priest. Who is in between you and master will become priest. In Tamil they say Gurukkal. Why they say Gurukkal, no? Gurukkala, Gurukkala, Purnala, Gurukkal. He always goes between you and the God. That's why he is called Gurukkal. And he will become priest. He will become just dead priest. Now the story has to be understood in a totally different way. New dimension. Actually, in Nityanandam, I started from this part only. The earlier part I did not tell. The earlier part is the original, from the beginning of the story. See, now it's totally a mystical or esoteric story. All devatas are the positive thoughts which is raising in you. Joyful thoughts which is raising in you. Which gives you joy. All demons are depressive thoughts which is raising in you. Negative thoughts. All demons are depressive thoughts. All devatas are positive thoughts. Be unclutched. The technique is the spindle. Technique is the spindle. And the tortoise, which is balancing the technique properly, is the Guru, Vishnu. Vishnu's, maybe we can say Guru's different form. One form of the Master. When you unclutch, when you decide to unclutch, both the thoughts will pull you this side and this side. Understand? One more important thing. Till you start the unclutching, your negative thoughts and positive thoughts will be opposing each other. The moment you start unclutching, both of them will join together and attack you. Because first time you became conscious, Pratyagatma Chaitanya, individual consciousness gets awakened. Whenever an individual consciousness gets awakened, neither negative thoughts nor positive thoughts can have their influence over you. It's like a state parties. Take care that central party does not enter into your state. See, both of them will be enemies. State parties. Two parties. But when it comes to the central party, both of them will join. Either you win or I will win. But we will not allow the central party. Central party should not come into the state. Same thing. If the central party comes in, neither positive nor negative will be having a place there. Individual consciousness, if it is awakened, neither positive thought nor negative thoughts will have power over you. Then both of them join suddenly and start churning you left and right. A real left and right. If you have went through the churning, you know. If you have gone through the churning, you know. A depression which is unimaginable will come out of you. Understand? Hormonal building in your body will give life to the memory stored in your muscles. An important thing. Now you should understand an important truth. You can sit straight a little bit. And the moment I start hormonal, everybody will sit straight now. See, once you finish the physical sex act, the same memory which was so colorful before the act does not have any more power over you. And slowly hormonal pressure gets built in your body for next 5 days or 10 days. But in the West, no need for 5-10 days. 5 or 10 days, every thought which comes related to sex create a little bit of that hormonal pressure. Or your body also gets ready for the next act. If your body is filled with the hormones, means ready for the next sexual act, the same visualization will be so colorful and so powerful. Memory of the same person, same imagination, will be so attractive before the physical act. The moment the physical act is done, the hormone is released, hormonal pressure comes down, the same visualization does not have any more power over you. Am I right? Same thing here also. Just the same thing here also. You will have same ordinary thought which did not have too much power over you, which did not create too much of depression on you, will be creating too strong depression over you because your hormonal pressure is prone for depression. Understand, during churning, normally, for example, if you have a thought, what will happen if my son dies? It may not give you too much depression. But during churning, during Nityananda, when that pulling and pushing is going on, the same thought will create, literally you will see that visualization in front of you, and your body will have so much of pressure of depression. Now, whatever was putting you in depression during Nityanandam, remember, they won't have power over you. Try. They won't have power over you. At that time, even though I myself sit with you and tell you, Are, this is the truth, you tell, no, whatever you say, I know the meaning of the word, but I am not, I can't. I know. This Nityanandam is a very dangerous program. No, really, very dangerous program. Because literally I will be churning. All those things will be coming out. At least earlier the same thought was not creating too much depression. Now the same thought will be creating so much depression in me. Why, you know? All possible worst experiences and best experiences will happen to you, so that no experience can imbalance you. No experience can imbalance you. See, you have a lot of anticipation or expectation of worst experiences in your system, then best experiences. If you have 100 memories, 90 of them will be somewhere related to your worst memories or your worst anticipations, worst expectations. Only 10 of them will be positive expectations, positive thoughts. So understand, 90% of them are worst means. So naturally depression will be the first thing to come out. And not only that, any small which I say will even hurt you. I have seen, during Nityanandam I am very careful. Because these fellows are waiting to run away. No, they are waiting to run away. They are waiting to run away. Not only that, when you unclutch, every part of your body will experience tiredness in the initial level. Because only that will get released. Depression is tiredness. That will get released. And another one important difficult thing is, not only your depression will get released, suddenly you will have small powers. That is what is this Sanghanidhi coming out, Badmanidhi coming out, the Kamadhyana coming out, Kalpavriksha coming out, and all the Haas coming out, Apsaras coming out. Apsaras coming out is a fantasy is coming out. Kalpavriksha coming out is your Anya coming out. From each chakra one will come out. One will come out. So from each chakra, one thing will come out. All those things will start coming out. The difficulty is, because you are already in loneliness of depression, you will catch apsaras and start living with them. That is why, during Nityanandam, I'll be very careful that nobody consoles the other. Nobody supports the other. If somebody supports you, you will fall in love with that person, thinking that this person is great. It is not that person is great. Your loneliness is too bad. Do not ever decide to marry if you are under depression or loneliness. You will choose Apsara. Means what? You are in trouble. Apsara will be beautiful till the child comes out. That is why the Apsara, the Vishwamitra story, same. The moment she comes with the child, Apsara will be beautiful till you have responsibility. That is what the child means. As you see, Apsara will be beautiful because both of you don't have responsibilities. No commitment. Just run around. Only when the commitment comes, you will understand, oh God, the fantasy is not worthy of commitment. Then, problem will start. Apsara is fantasy. Then the churning goes left and right. Person who is aware of number of thoughts happening during the negative side and the positive side, he only continues the journey. The snake, Vasugi, is your individual consciousness. Understand? Your individual consciousness. Your individual consciousness is pulled one side by the negative thoughts, pulled other side by positive thoughts, and the technique is inserted into you. Be unclutched. Exactly. The technique is there in the center. And if you allow, if you say yes to positive thoughts, they will just pull you one side. And you will see whole life is hell, heaven. whole life is heaven. If you turn this side and say yes to negative thoughts, they will just pull you the other side. Whole life will be hell. You are supposed to be steady with the technique of be unclutched. You should neither get imbalanced through the positive thought nor get imbalanced through negative thought. If you get imbalanced even one side, the churning will stop. Churning will stop. Just sit, neither being taken away by the negative nor being taken away by the positive, and allow the churning to happen. The immediate result of the aware, the churning with awareness is you will get some powers. You will get some powers, small, small miracle powers. As I told you that old cell phone, second-hand camera, all the garage sale items, items which comes in garage sale, all those items you will get. If you get stuck with a garage sale item, you will never get home, moksha. You will never get the truth. You will be stuck there itself. You will be stopped there itself. And one important thing, one big danger which can happen is tiredness of individual consciousness being churned. Not having patience to go through the whole process. That is the worst thing. Nobody can save you if that happens. Nobody can save you. If that happens, you vomit your impatience as a hatred towards the master. That is what? Poison. Alahala. That is what is poison. Hatred towards the person who gave you Mandara, Merugiri. Understand? Technique is the place where master is sitting. He gave his own place for you. But you throw poison towards the same person who gave you the Mandara. One more thing, you should understand an important word. Mandara Giri means Mantra Giri. Technique is the mantra. Be unclutched is the mantra. Is the Mandara Giri. Mantra Giri. You are hatred towards the master if you vomit it because of your impatience, your ignorance. That is what is poison. Alahala. Alahala. One important thing, once you vomit alahala, even your negative and positive thoughts will disappear from you. Suddenly you will feel relieved. Whoever ran away from Nityanandam felt that is what for next 1 month. For next 1 month, oh God, I am out. Let all this nonsense be lost, be away from me. Let me breathe fresh air. How long? Till the poison comes to your mouth. Till the poison comes to your mouth. But compassionate master is so compassionate, he does not bother. He takes even that poison and swallows. He takes even that poison and swallows. And his own very expression only comes out as a tortoise and balances and continues the technique to happen in you. Understand? He is Shiva and he is Vishnu. He only comes and acts as a tortoise. He takes care the technique continues to be working in you, alive. And he takes care the poison is also swallowed. Poison is also swallowed and he takes care that churning continues. The process continues. Understand? When the process continues, by the grace of the master balancing the technique properly, then comes Amrita, enlightenment. Then comes Amrita, enlightenment. One important thing, even after Amrita, enlightenment comes out, few negative thoughts just jump and come along with the positive thoughts and want to get empowered by those Amrita. What are those few negative thoughts which can come and join and stand with the positive thoughts? What are those thoughts, you know? I did everything. What did he do? I did everything. What did he do? That is what is Rahu and Ketu. He does not even have a head, but he will be jumping. He does not even have a leg, but he will be dancing. Neither head nor leg. Shadowish thoughts. But Master will see that that thoughts does not get empowered. They do not get the Amrita. Understand, when Amrita goes inside, your inner space is cleaned. If at all some thoughts are given life, that will be only Devatas, good thoughts. That will only be good thoughts. And they will also lose its power when you relax completely out of the body. When you leave the body, even those positive thoughts will not be there. They will disappear. As long as your body is alive, the positive thoughts will have power. That is called Jivan Mukti. You will not be touched by any thoughts. If at all there will be few thoughts in your inner space, they will be positive. It is called Jivan Mukti. When you leave the body, they also will not have power over you. It is called Videha Mukti. It is called Videha Mukti. Jivan Mukti means you are alive, there will be few thoughts, maybe some good thoughts, they will have power over you just because of your freedom, choice. That is Jivan Mukti. Videha Mukti means even those thoughts will not be there. A person who allowed this journey, who had the passions to go through this journey, who had the passions to go through the whole process, enjoys Amrita. That's why we say, Tyage naika Amritatva manasuhu. Tyaga means, understand, Tyaga does not mean throwing away whatever you have. Tyaga means having passions to go through the churning in the presence of the Master. Tyaga is more like a sacrifice your time, not the products which you are having. Understand? I am giving a new definition for renunciation. Tyaga means ability to sacrifice your time, not the products or the properties which you are having in your name. That is the truth. Tyage naika amritatva manasuhu. Without the sacrifice, the Amritatva enlightenment is not achieved. Whoever has got the patience to go through the journey, I have seen not only Nityanandam, even if you start staying around the Master like this programs, the churning starts happening. Churning starts happening. Because, you see, by very presence of the Master, you start getting cleaned. You go to the Master to get yourself cleaned only. That is why I always take care. Even if you don't feel little connected, or if you don't feel little disturbed, do not try to be around me so close and all. I always take care. Why do you think that I am so careful and choosy? Because if these fellows don't, if they are not in tune, and if they sit in front of me, even a small word can hurt them. I will not be talking to them. It will hurt them. It will hurt them. Once like this only about NSP I was talking. It will completely take care. I will be there. You will never die alone. That fellow started telling why it did not happen for me in NSP. He did not even do NSP. He did only Atmasmarana. He has not even understood that. And He is shouting. The problem is, they are waiting to get hurt. Nothing can be done. That is why I am so choosy about what to talk, to whom to talk. I always tell, if you are not feeling connected, if you have some irritation about my activities or about my talking words, better escape as early as possible. This is not the place for you to be. Understand? I am so compassionate, I let you to be around me in all moods, all ways. Usually the so-called masters will never let you around them so close. Why, you know? You will find out they are not enlightened. See, 24 hours you can't act. 24 hours they can't act. Very difficult. 24 hours they can't act. But with a living master, real master, he wants as much as possible to people to be around. People to see them, see him in all close zones, all close quarters, so that they will imbibe the body language. They will imbibe the body language. They will imbibe the life. They will imbibe the whole thing. See, when so close, people stay, but nobody loses the respect. Nobody takes it for granted. Because the heart always realizes the truth. I always tell people, if you are not feeling little connected, better escape as early as possible. Because you will not only will be finding fault, you will be hurting yourself. Understand? I won't bother at all. I will never be bothered. Even yesterday, we were all jumping and dancing. If somebody is hurt, you will think I will be bothered? We will never bother. We won't even remember. Get lost. Who cares? We will not even bother. But the person who gets hurt will constantly hurt himself. We just don't want that people to get hurt themselves. That is all. Is the truth. When you fall in tune, that's what I say. Tyage naika. Having patience. Dedicating little time. Sacrificing little time. To go through the journey is tyaga. That is tyaga. One more important thing. In this whole drama, actually nothing else is required except the patience. Because he gives you the mantra, he himself balances the mantra, and he himself lets the churning process also happen. See, the beauty of the tortoise is, it can rotate the spindle so beautifully, you don't even need sometime the devatas and asuras for churning. He himself can rotate the spindle and finish the whole churning. Understand? He doesn't even need good thoughts or bad thoughts to pull you left and right. He himself can beautifully balance the spindle and just get the amrita out. Get the whole thing out. So, why he took tortoise form and balanced, you know? Tortoise can take all his senses into him. So, during this journey, you need to take all your senses into you. Only then you will have that balance to go through the journey. Otherwise, through someone's sense, all your energy will go away. Through someone's sense, all your energy will go away. During the journey, you need to be in seclusion. That is why the 10 days, I want you to be away from society. I want you to be away from the all the so-called routine. Seclusion. So that the passions for the churning can happen. Blessed are those who have patience to go through the process. Blessed are those who have found the master and patience. They will always enjoy the nectar, eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. How many time I tell this story, I also don't feel bored. How many time I told this story, I don't know. But people also don't feel bored. Hmm? That's nice. Something new comes up, na?
It's beneficial.
Understanding.
The shell of the turtle is so hard. It's been used as a shield during the war.
Oh.
That is the that how hard it is in it. It does.
Yes.
Beautiful, and still it is able to.
Balance.
The water when that to go into infusion and infusion. But some external stimulus
keep that person. That is only churning, not external stimulus. It's only churning. Just be with the churning. Shall we start? Ahimsa, ready?
You will take Ramayana later on, probably.
Ah, yes, later on.